to Emmanuel. And I can remember once I was at Emmanuel, and
I saw this person, because it's an old theatre, and you've got the aisle going down, like you're going, you know.
And I'm sitting on the, what was the left, where is that, right, left. Amen. And I could see this young man in the middle of the aisle, and he never sat down.
I know him.
And after service, I went up to him because also one of his friends, I knew as well from high school, and we're all, you know, friends together. And I went up to him and said, I know you used to go to Emmanuel. And from that, because I remember when I came here, I went to church and someone invited me home for dinner, and I said, I'm not going back because, you know, in Jamaica we don't eat from everyone and anybody. And because I didn't want to say that to a person, I said, I'm not going back. And for months I didn't go back. And this time when I decided, I'm going back. And I saw him. And I wasn't filled yet. And, you know, within that time, I was like, this is it. And we talked a little bit. And then, you know, throughout that time, and I got filled in 1995, not long, I went back to January, and in February I got filled. And I was in his new converts class. And I was there every Sunday, and I learned so much. He had so much to share. Amen? And then he sort of took me under his wings. And one day I was at church and said, oh, Sister Annette, I want you to teach a new converts class. Yeah, right. To teach a new converts class. And I'm thinking, how am I going to do this? Right, you and Sister so-and-so are going to do this, and you're going to share, you're going to do that. And that's still in him. He tries to mentor people. He helps to improve your skill. I was a very shy person.
True.
Very shy. And, you know, I moved from the youth department into the new converts, teaching new converts. One day I remember I ended up teaching adult class. And I'm thinking, what's going on? But because of Pastor Sanguinetti, I can say I've come out of my shell. I've been through much. You know, Mr. Money was there as well. But, you know, because of what he's done, this is me. Amen? This is me. My mom talks about it as well because she had the blood clot on her lung. And, you know, in hospital, Thursday night, he prayed for her. He prayed for her. She'll never forget it. And, you know, the phone cut off, and she said, oh, Lord, if you want to cut off, whatever, try to cut off it. It's not going to work, you know. But I'm giving God thanks for Pastor Sanguinetti. I'm giving God, it's a true blessing in the lives of people that you enter, honestly. Amen. You know, but at times, you always have the ones that don't like you because the Lord bless you so much, you just can't do anything else without telling you. Right? You can't do anything but just to give God thanks. He says, in all things, hallelujah, in the good times and the bad times, hallelujah, I will give him thanks. Amen? Anybody else want to give a quick thing? We've got about 5 minutes. Anyone want to say something? Say one.
Oh. Praise the Lord. I'm just reading first because I came here by introduction of my sister Yvonne. And when I came here the first time, I didn't know this man from nowhere. I saw him the first time. And the teaching that went forth that night, I gained so much in one night. He's a very good teacher. Everyone can testify to that. And he makes sure that you learn. And since I've been here, I've heard a lot, sir. Thank God for him. Thank God for the man of God. He uses wisdom and he's a very good teacher. And talking about preaching, oh my God. He's an excellent, spirit-filled, anointed speaker as well. And I learned a lot from him, and I just want to continue. Just pray for him. You know, all of us, just pray for him. He's got a ministry that I admire so much. God bless you, sir. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. I too can say I give him so many trouble that
Sometimes they pass the same one. Amen. I'm here about, I think, about 6 years ago. Really, really thank God for Pastor Sanguinetti and what he has done in my life. He has made me to be a lady that I was very, so shy. Not only that, because I get so many beaten. I didn't want to trust nobody, but coming to new life, I can't trust people. I never usually eat from people neither. It was a new one. We went all the way to, and I said, you must say, man, not gonna eat from them. It's not that I scorn them, but we are Jamaicans. We don't go around and eat. So thank God for passing. And I know he has a ministry that is going far beyond what is here.
Thank you.
And that's why the devil tries, but he's a loser.
Amen.
And our prayer for this year to continue. And I know God's going to bless me because I'm going to buy my vehicle. And I know
I've been coming here 6 years over there, 5 and a half years. And I mean, when I first met you, I've had, you know, I hold you in high esteem, and I still do. And you know, a lot of times people say to me, why do you travel all the way across the river? And I'm like, well, when I was raving, I'd go anywhere, Birmingham, Nottingham, anywhere it was, like, once I wanted to go, I'd go. And I mean, when I'm not here, I feel like I have to be here. And every time I come back, you know, you've never made me feel out of place, or even when, you know, I know I'm wrong and you talk to me and you say, Shelly, you know you're wrong, why, you know, and I'd say to you, but Pastor, you know, I'll give you that attitude, and then I'll calm down and say, actually, you're right. But, you know, not growing up with a father figure and having that is very important. So continue to do that even when we give you that fight. Just
I'm just getting in fast to the car. That's just a little bit, I said, for him as well. You know, she's always presenting cars, and she sent this one for you. We told her that we're going to love you. But let's see if it's going to be like this. Hold up. Singing and the words and all those of you who've shared, it's just a blessing to me just to hear you share, Sister Annette, as well. Some of the things that I tend to forget from time to time, I realize that you're taking them in, you haven't forgotten. Amen. And Sister Shelley, I mentioned her because that touched me. When someone haven't a father figure and see you as a pastor these days and see you that way, it means, especially that means a whole lot to me. Amen? And so I want to honor that. I want to honor those of you who have signed the cards, those of you who just shared.
And I, and just about everybody, Brother Andrew was giving us the serenade from the from the music, but we did God's praise, and Sister Yvonne as well. And that's a testament, Sister Yvonne. You've actually hit the nail on the head, the idea of just being able to help people to come out of their shell a little bit and to try to help to build their confidence in some way, shape, or form. Brother David as well. And all those that have missed, I'm sure some of you have various things to say. I was so blessed also. I mean, I got up this morning and I was so honored to have my friends from one from South Africa. He's asking me right now to come and run a conference there, but he was wishing me happy birthday. My friends from Ohio and Cincinnati, Ohio rather, and just about various people. I mean, my Facebook is loaded with also the happy birthday and so on and so forth. But every person's word is very, very important, my children. And you know, most importantly, there are two persons that I look for a happy birthday. And this, I understand that some people haven't got mom or dad. But when my dad called me and my mom called me and say happy birthday, and my mom always tells me that she is proud of me. Amen?
Amen.
I'm having a conference, I said, post up the brochure, let her see it. And one person wrote on the Facebook page, you know, your mom was at work, you know, and all day she's been talking about how it's my big son's birthday and she's carrying. And you know, those are the things, it's amazing. And I hope I'm getting over the message that we don't have to be a large church to be a community. And the community is very, very important. Amen?
Amen.
And so thank you all. Thank you all, the leadership, Mr. Mandy, everyone who's just shared in the way you can. And there's a song that says, little is much, but God is in it. There is a crown, and you can win it in Jesus' name. Shall we just lift our hands to the Lord?
Amen.
I'm not going to Yeah, you've got to hand this up. Good God, I'm not going to let anyone construct me in their image. Their image is already marred. Their image is already messed up. Their image is already thwarted with all sort of irregularities and problems. But I'm in the image of God. Can I preach tonight for about 10 more minutes? Is there ever a time you have read in the Bible where God was ever defeated? You have